Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can create a card interaction like the one that you can see here. So the way this works is that when I press the letters WASD, and I can move my card to the right and to the left, and it will be rotating and moving similar to how a card would do in real life. So we will see how we can use the game controls plus physics to create an experience like this. Alright, so I have my scene in here, and this scene is available in the Spline library, so you can actually go to the library and make a duplicate of this file so you can follow this tutorial. So in this scene we have this car, and we also have these trees and forests, and also these objects in here for camping. And if I go to the play mode right now, you can see that my car is falling, and also the trunks here are also falling. But if I try to move by pressing the WASD keys, nothing is really happening. So the reason for this is because we don't really have a game control attached to the car. So that's gonna be my first step, right? I'm going to add a new event, and then this event is going to be a game controls event. And right away, if I go to the play mode, you can see that now if I press WSD, the car is moving, but it's moving in a weird way. You can see that the camera is also rotating, which is maybe a little confusing. So let's go back, and the first thing is that I want the camera to not rotate when I'm moving. So I just, instead of orienting the camera based on the angle of the object, I want it to be like a normal movement. This opens up this other parameter here. So I don't want any rotation up and down, and also don't want any rotation left and right. So if we go to the play mode again, I try to move the object. And now you can see that because previously the object was moving with the camera, and now the camera is not moving, it feels like the object is basically just sliding. The reason for this is because the keys for movement are only changing the position. You can see here, for example, the D is for move right, and the A is for move left. I want the D to be for rotation to the right, and A to be the rotation to the left. So now if I go to the play again, you can see that when I rotate here, it's actually moving in the right way, because now when I press in A and D, it's rotating to the right and to the left. But I do notice that it's a little slow, so maybe we can duplicate the amount of speed in terms of position, and also the amount of speed in terms of rotation. So basically we just want it to be faster. Then we go again here and see how it works. And that is a lot better, I think. Definitely more interesting. Yeah, that's cool. All right, you can also change the delay that the camera has. So for example, right now the delay is very small, but we can use like a second. And then if we go to the play mode again, you can see that the car is moving faster than the camera. So the camera takes a little bit to catch up. I actually prefer the previous one because it feels a little more exciting for this particular experience, but there might be cases in which you want like a longer delay. Here's an example in which the camera is moving a little slower than the character, and you can see how when I do all of these, the camera is basically catching up a little later. So for this particular experience, the delay on the position for the camera works better. If we go to the editor mode and we select the game controls in here, you can see that this one does have like 1 second delay, but all of the other parameters are actually quite similar. All right, I hope you like this tutorial. Please let us know in the comments if you would like to see more similar tutorials to this one. See you in the next one. Bye bye.